So the economy's headed in the right direction. But for a lot of Americans, for Racine and a lot of other communities, it's not heading there fast enough.
President Barack Obama brings his message of economic recovery to the Badger State. Now at 5, live team coverage of the president's speech and the questions supporters and critics had for the commander-in-chief. Good evening, I'm Kathy Michaelby.
And I'm Terry Sater. And for Toya tonight, the president focused on economic recovery. During today's visit, he said his economic stimulus plan helped prevent another Great Depression.
We have live team coverage tonight. 12 News' Mike Anderson talked to Republican leaders and union workers who came to protest the president's speech. And we begin with Kent Wayne Scott. Kent, a pretty friendly crowd for the president today.
Yeah, it was. And, you know, the president did come here to talk about the economy. His message was positive in tone, but there wasn't a lot in the way of specifics. Instead, it was an opportunity to hear from the people of this community and to talk up his economic policies here in Racine, a place that continues to suffer very tough times.
I know the towns like Racine are still hurting from this recession. You know, this city has the second highest unemployment rate in the state.
The president chose one of Wisconsin's hardest-hit communities to talk up an improving economy. It's something he says isn't always easy to do.
It's hard to argue sometimes things would have been a lot worse. Right? So people kind of say, yeah, but unemployment's still at 9.6. Yes, but it's not 12 or 13.
In fact, one point he tried to make to those in the room was that they've received a tax cut that they may not even be aware of.
Economists will tell you if you give that tax break to people each time they get a paycheck as opposed to in one lump sum, then they're more likely to spend it, and that is a better way to stimulate the economy. It wasn't a good way to advertise the tax cut, so if I had been just thinking politics, I would have sent you one big check with my picture on it and said, here's your tax cut.
His message that the economy is improving may be a hard sell in a place like Racine, but most here were happy to hear it, and even happier just to have the president come to town.
It was cool. I've never met a president before, and we were sitting up close, so it was just exciting to see everything that went into it and to meet him, and he was very personable.
For him to even come out here and take the time to come to small Racine and see what's on people's minds means a lot to a lot of people around here.
And this was a town hall format, an opportunity for the folks here to ask questions, to ask the president about things like education funding, support for troops and veterans, and efforts to keep jobs here in the U.S. And speaking of jobs, there was one group here in particular that was really focused today on hundreds of jobs, their own jobs that could be in jeopardy at Bucyrus. Coming up at 6 o'clock, the surprise when the president didn't address the one thing that a lot of folks were anxious to hear about here today. Reporting live in Racine, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.
All right, thanks, Kent.